just point straight down and burn all this delta V at the tank. Because right now that was like, it was like 20 days or something. I think he was going to get home. Let's F5 it just in case I screw up. And burn it straight down at Kerbin. No, that did not work. I need to burn this way. All right, I need to pull my... That works right there. Straight down at Kerbin. Now I can burn straight down. And all I'm doing here is using up my Delta V to get home faster. I don't need the 1,600 meters per second Delta V. I am going to hit Kerbin, as you may see. I'm not going to miss Kerbin. I'm going to hit just on the daylight side of Kerbin. We would almost be hitting the KSC there. But not because, you know, Kerbin's going to rotate out from under us. Let's tweak it a little bit. I'm just wasting Delta V is all that I'm doing. I want to hit Kerbin. Yeah, there was no... And still, even in science mode here, I don't need to land at KSC. I can basically just burn straight down towards her. That means we're going to get home a lot faster. Look, this node is now 6 days instead of 20 days. We will check to see what our time will be when we actually get there. But I really just want Jeb to come home. I hope we don't hit the moon. I keep seeing Mooner encounters here. These are Mooner encounters flying by. I hope we don't impact the moon instead. That would be awesome. Again, I'm just trying to burn straight down, and you can see how it affects it, right? What is this now? This is now 4 days. I still think we'll have plenty of time. No, we will definitely, I guarantee you, we will hit Kerbin, we will hit terminal velocity as we're coming into the atmosphere. I'm not worried about wiping out the Kerbal race or anything like that. I'm actually more inclined trying to keep my, there we go. Just doing these little burnings straight towards Kerbin. I'm watching Kerbin so that I don't miss. I don't want to give it so much velocity and have it go off one side. That's why I'm watching Kerbin here. But again, just trying to get home with the quickness so that we can collect this sweet, sweet science that we collected from solar orbit, which was a ridiculous amount of science, obviously. I can totally eat some pretzels while I do this. Snyder's of Hanover jalapeno pretzels are freaking delicious. Coming straight on down. We'll leave 44 meters per second of fuel in there just in case. The DOS Comet. Yes, you raise very valid points. If you have deadly reentry installed, do not do what DOS is doing. It is not going to work. It is not going to turn out well for you. There we go. Jeb needs to go collect his experiments since he is hurtling towards Kerbin at what? This is totally how NASA does it. It's like, we got extra fuel. Let's just burn straight at Earth. I just need to collect all my experiments now because, again, I'm gonna toss off that end part. I may need to use the entire thing as a huge ablative heat shield. Collect data. I got it. This is some freaking valuable experimental data, by the way. We're going to get like 500 or something. See it re-enter from the KSC. You know, we have a very small chance that we'll land somewhere near the KSC. I didn't calculate it at all. Almost impossible to calculate. It looks like we've already cleaned this one out. Yeah, that's the one we got over the moon and already cleaned out, I guess. Let's collect this one. Oh, yeah, Jeb, just bounce against it there. Burned up on reentry. As soon as it hits the atmosphere, like 1 meter in, it burns up. Get it, Jeb. Why can't you pull that out? There you go. Remove data. Do we need another EVA report? Nope, we don't need that one. Yes, I do, K9. I do need to do a deadly reentry KSA. I am definitely down with that, and I will get that set up in the next week or so. Again, Kerbal Space Academy is a long-term thing for me. I want to do it over time. Let's see if we can get back in. So just because I don't do it this week does not mean that I'm not interested in doing it. Did it fix? I know. I'll tell you when I'm going to collect my data. Where's Kerbin even at? Jeez, let me point at it. Show me where Kerbin is. Whoa, there's Kerbin. We're going to be coming in hot. because our orbital velocity should start to increase. So now that we've collected all of our science, it's interesting. Our orbital velocity is increasing very, very slowly. But it should start picking up the faster, the closer we get to the planet. I want to be going like 3 or 4 kilometers per second when we get down there. Let's go see how much we burned that delta V. What would the node look like now? Oh my gosh, I can't even... give me a node. 2 days. So instead of 20 days, we did 2 days. Hey, Bob. We'll be here. We will see what's going on here. At NASA, buzzing the tower from solar orbit is frowned upon. We've only got 2 days to go here. That Kerbin is going to come up really freaking fast. I guarantee you. We'll look at it like this. Siri, where is Kerbin? Straight down. Right now, we're falling straight towards Kerbin. Let's see here. Snyder's pretzel salt and pepper combo bag. McLovin' it. This is Snyder's of Hanover jalapeno. I don't know if it's green screening it or not. Jalapeno flavored pretzels. Let's do one more time warp thing. Watch Kerbin come up. Is that Minmus? There was Minmus. Flying by Minmus. That would have been awesome if we got a Minmus encounter. How is this not a Minmus encounter? Look how close we are to Minmus. What? Oh my gosh, I almost wish I hadn't spilled. Oh, wow. We were so close to flying by Minmus. Look how close Minmus is out the window there. Minmus is really tiny. That's actually really close to Minmus, y'all. Oh, well, we missed it this time. We probably could have done a Minmus flyby. That would have been awesome. What's up, Matthew K16? Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. We are just about to return home here, bringing home some sweet, sweet science. We almost got a Minmus flyby. I can't believe we almost got a Minmus flyby. That was awesome. Now our orbital velocity is increasing. I hope I'm going like 3 kilometers per second or something when I re-enter. I also hope that I re-enter on the day side. Let's see. Oh man, they are. Dude, McLovin it. They're totally freaking delicious. Kerbin, here I am. I'm coming home. My pro flying skills crashed my internet. That's totally what happened. We'll turn this on back around. There we go. Pointer tail end. Let's get on home. Crashing her into the... wow, we're going to come right down on the daytime side here, too. Why do I have those other things in chutes? That's interesting. We are going to be coming down hot in the mountains, it looks like, y'all. Jeez. We'll see how that goes. I almost wonder if I shouldn't just pop all the chutes and not decouple. I think I'll try that, actually. Hey, Matthew K16, thanks for the follow. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. Caboose, the cat's out of the bag. I have a feeling you guys were totally screwing with me. Because on my side, I saw the rest of the stream and my internet even crashed. So, you know. Let's see here. I am coming down hot. I guarantee you that. I didn't even get that into the right stage, apparently. We'll see how this does. That would be a serious science haul. But all I did, I did a flyby of the moon. I went into solar orbit. I turned back around. I burned towards Kerbin. Those solar orbit things are worth, like, what were they? 200 or 300 each? We'll see when we get back here. We're going 3.6 kilometers per second as we enter the atmosphere. Folks, prepare for fireworks. There are some fireworks. Log temperature. Really freaking hot is the temperature right now. How many G's? I don't even know. Look at these G's. The G meter is freaking pegged. 4, 3. Better pop the chutes. That wasn't even time warp, y'all. Better pop the chutes, I said. That wasn't even time warp. We went through the atmosphere in like 3 seconds. I wonder, will Kerbal Engineer show me my max G's? Da-da-da-da, G-force. No, it would have showed me my... Wait, is that my max G right there? My max G's were 2,400 G's coming into the atmosphere. 2,400 G's was my max, according to Kerbal Engineer. That was freaking fantastic. I'm going to go back and watch that video and see how long it took us to go through the atmosphere. I wonder what the too hot temperature said. Does it? It doesn't actually tell you what the temperature was. Did it? Like if I go to review data, drat! It doesn't tell us what the temperature was during that. That's lame. Keep the data though. I would be so dead with FAR. You are absolutely correct. 2,500, 2,400 G's basically. That's a lot of G's. Made of very sturdy stuff. Actually, they're just not affected by gravity. I think it is. They're not affected by it. Not gravity. They're not affected by G-forces. Not affected by forces whatsoever. So we are going to return home. We're going to have quite a science haul here. 5.1 meters. We may ablade that off. Hopefully we ablade that engine off. Pop it for me. Nope. Don't roll. Dag nabbit. That's fine. Where am I? Do I need a surface sample from wherever I am? It almost isn't even worth it. But let's have a look. EVA report. Over the deserts. I'll take it. Jib is going to let go here. Wait, F5 right quick in case it crashes the game. Oof. Falls on his little Kerbany noggin. Oh, we need to store this right quick, I think. Walk over. Store it. Store experiments. Excellent. Now give me an EVA report from the desert. Yeah, all right, didn't need that. Take a surface sample. Woohoo, another 9 science. I don't even care what that says. Store experiments. I'm not going to be able to board, though, am I? Oh, I can grab. Oof. Yes, and board. And recover. Excellent. Little Jeb, are you okay? The best thing to get with science was things that get you more science. Look at that. 867 science earned on that mission. All the rest of the time that I spent walking around KSC and all that sort of junk, we almost didn't even need it because we got 867 science. Look at the different science here. Freaking 75. Where's the big ones? There you go. Material study in space high over the sun was 275. Observation from the goo was 110. Space near the moon was 30. Material study near the moon was 75. That solar orbit is worth so much. Just going just out and then back into it. Wow, that's a lot of freaking science. We can unlock a whole lot of stuff now, y'all. Material study over the moon was good. Oh my gosh, that solar orbit really made that mission. The solar orbit totally made the mission. So let's go over here and look at what I unlocked in the order I unlocked it in. The first thing that I did, I went down the lower tree right here because that gets us the mystery goo container. You have to get that. That gets us the Science Junior right down here. I think this one was 45 to unlock. We could look at this. Yeah, 45. So I think these were 15. This was like 5 or something. So for 5 plus 15, it's 15, isn't it? Yeah, about 15. So that's 20 plus 45. We were able to get the goo. We have the Kerbin, and the Kerbal himself, so our EVA report soil samples, and we have the Science Junior. That's all I've been using, those three parts, basically up to here. So what I did first was I went down this lower part to get to that. I grabbed this so that I could get the science, the mobile processing lab, that was important, and the thermometer. And I want to grab these docking ports now. That was 160. What else do we have? Is this going to give me smaller docking ports? Yes, the Clampo John Jr. to the tune of 300. I'm going to research that as well. Hey, here we can see, K9, if you're here, see how this is grayed out? The requirement for the nuke engine is actually both of these, the heavier rocketry and this. So I need heavier rocketry and specialized construction in order to get the nuke. That's how it looks when it's you need both of them. When you only need one, like look at this one. This one you need advanced construction, which we have, or aerodynamics, which we don't have. This is an ore, and I can actually research it. It's just the nuke there that you can't do that on. So what else are we going to need? We're going to need some power generation, we know. I think heavier rocketry is going to be important to get that mainsail, so that's going to cost us 300. Can we get... Yes, those are little baby solar panels. We could totally get going like that. So that would be 90. That's good. I want all of this stuff. I want everything. I don't even know where reaction control thrusters are. Where are they even at? And then I want to grab heavier rocketry, I believe. That's going to be 160. What else? Crazed. We did two things. We ran around. We did some biome farming on Kerbin itself. Ladders are important. Not on Minmus, dude. We're going to Minmus. Ladders, we don't need those. We don't need those things. But that would also get us this. For 160, that may be worth it. Do I have RCS yet? I don't even know. I wish I could see. This is reaction control. I feel like it's after this, though. 45 plus this. Plus the barometer. 160 plus 45. That would be one. Nope, that'd be 205. That wouldn't do it. Basic control. Yeah, I don't know. Let's see. There's no RCS there. There's no RCS in there. We may not even have RCS. It may be something about here. This is flight control. Anybody want to confirm where RCS comes from? I am just looking around. And I don't think that I have it yet. Here's advanced rocketry. We went straight to heavy rocketry. We didn't need advanced rocketry. Can't use the pressure thing on Minmus anyways. Yeah, don't forget the batteries and snacks. We do have a way to generate some power. And when we get the RTG, we'll be able to upgrade the craft in the next session. So we don't need these more advanced solar panels or anything like that yet. What else? Hey, you can totally watch this after the fact. Cray is 77. RCA is 90 or above. So that's going to be past this, I think, right? I have a feeling it's going to be this plus that. Huh. RCS. RCA. You know, whatever. I have a feeling it's going to be downstream from that. Can anybody confirm that if I research flight control, RCS is right here? The 90 node after that. I really hope that that's what it is. Yeah, you need flight control. All right, let's just research it. Then that gives us all the RCS for another 90. That's what we wanted to do. So what have I done, right? What have I done? I researched things that give me more science first. So I went over to here to get the Jew. To get the Jew? Yes, the Jew helps me research science. My bad, slip of the tongue. I got the mystery goo, mystery Jew container. I don't even know. I got the mystery goo first. And then I went straight for the Science Junior because that Science Junior is worth a lot. The next thing, all I really needed to do next was fly into a solar orbit. I did a Mooner flyby. I went into that solar orbit doing the goo and the Science Junior on the Mooner flyby and doing the goo and the Science Junior in the solar orbit, plus a little bit of stuff here and there, got me freaking over 800 science, which I used to undo docking ports, right? And I actually got two sets of docking ports. I got the larger Clampatron Junior, or the larger regular size Clampatrons and the Clampatron Juniors, right? Those were important. I really wish that I had the Clampatron Seniors, but I do not. What else do I have? There we go. So, in unlocking these things, I've done a couple different things. Number one, science. I want science. Number two, docking ports. I want docking ports. Number three, power generation. I want power generation. If you're going to build a vessel that you're going to retrofit and you don't have at least those things, you're going to have a bad time. But the science things that allow me to get more science, the docking ports, because I'm going to use the docking ports to upgrade my vessel, and the power generation, so I have some sort of power generation. Let us run back. I am going to spend just a couple minutes on beginning the build here. I've got 61 more science. I don't really think there's anything else I need to research. I might as well spend it on that, because next stop is going to be Minmus. This is 45. I might as well grab... Well, I can't grab that. I need three more science. I could go check the temperature on the launch pad and get that. Maybe I'll do that right quick. I don't know. I spent all week doing less than I've done in a few hours. As it turns out, Craze, this isn't my first rodeo. But I was trying to show you quick ways to get the science. If you want to watch this, I am going to upload it to YouTube eventually. It will be here on Twitch for the next week. If you click on my name, Das Valdez, up on the channel, you can look at all my past videos. Didn't I have a thermometer on here? Yes, I did. Let's launch this craft right quick and just see what the temperature on the launch pad is, which should give me enough. Let's see here. Just going to check that. YouTube channel and a Twitch channel. We have a YouTube channel, but Twitch is giving us trouble. I may not be the person. I've only been on Twitch myself for like 2 weeks, man. So I don't know. You could definitely send me a question. 2.4 science. That's exactly what we needed. Let's save that. We're just totally going to recover the vessel. Can I do a... Will this give me anything more? Let's see. 1.6 science. I'm rich. I'm science rich. Recover the whole rocket. Bring it back. McLovin, if you want to send me a message on Twitch, you can totally do that, and I will give you a response to whatever that question is. 4.0 science earned. But I definitely want to help you out however I can. A good way to get started in being helped out is to attend the Kerbal Space Academy sessions. So, yeah, exactly. A science bay rockets and jetpacks before they had thermometers. Doubling up thermometers on the next vehicle. I completely agree. Anything else we need? Heavier rocketry. That's it. We passed the big boosters and the skipper and the poodling. We went straight to the freaking... We went straight to the mainsail. That's freaking awesome. That has spent all our science. Let us run over. Yeah, no, what? Crazed. The first, like, 5 nodes that we unlocked, we just walked around KSC and did surface samples, basically. We actually rolled around. We had the science pin roller here. Maybe I can bring it up for you right quick. They didn't think of putting them on spaceships. Okay, Snuggly Squid. Dude, let me open this thing up. Save this. Make a new one. We totally had the... Well, I gotta put this on there, I guess. The Rolling Pin of Science. If you're new to gathering science, the Rolling Pin of Science will allow you... I'll drive it for you, whatever. Let's put another probe core on the other end, watch. The Rolling Pin of Science will allow you to roll around KSC. Save. Launch. This will allow you to farm some science from the KSC before you have a rover. Basically, it is a rover. It roves. That's a verb. By using the reaction control torque. You can turn it like this. Now we could totally, I don't have anything on there. I'll show you, you could do science on this. This is what I did at the beginning of the episode. 0.4 science, that's kind of lame. I can turn SAS on, and I can use the E to roll. Rolling, rolling, rolling. So this is my very early career science rover. I'm actually going to roll that other goo container off the launch pad down here. The launch pad was a biome. You can get science from that. You can roll down this way. And then once you're down here, look at this. Observe materials bay. That's going to give you a different biome. It's going to give you the KSC biome. Let's keep that data. We've already done this. You can also do the same thing for goo containers. There's a mystery goo from KSC. I've already done this a few times. Normally you'd get like from that. Sputnik hubcaps. I'm going to turn off SAS. I can turn this way. And I could totally turn on SAS and roll this way. And if I rolled far enough, I could actually leave the KSC. The mysterious Jews must be getting real dizzy. I could totally be off the KSC. It turns into grasslands just outside the fence. Apparently, you roll over the fence in the science rolling pin here. If I went this way, out there towards the island, I could... I don't know. I'd have to like stop to do it. Let's stop to do it. If I point towards the island, I could roll towards the biome called the shores. And I could roll all the way over here to the shores, and I could get the Mystery Goo and the Science Junior. I could get soil samples. I could get EVA reports. I could get flight over by hanging onto the ladder. Just using this right here, I think we collected like 200 science or something just rolling around the KSC. Corn chips is exactly right. You can also put this in a subassembly and launch it from the space plane hangar so it's on the runway. And the runway is a biome. You can totally get the runway biome. Just by launching this thing on the runway. Anyways, this is the rolling pin of science. We can roll it around the KSC, and we grabbed, I think, somewhere like at least 150 or 200 science just from rolling this thing with the goo containers and the science juniors around KSC. Anyways, that's the rolling pin of science. I didn't even have power generation yet. I had to put batteries on it. Look at the battery charge going up and down on there. 2,000. It's definitely not 2,000. Wait, what? My science rolling pin was definitely not 2,000, I guarantee you that. Let's recover Jeb here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to spend just a couple minutes. I'm actually 20 minutes over, I am 30 minutes over budget on Kerbal Space Academy here. Woohoo! 0.4 science! That's because we already rolled this thing all over the Space Center. Got all the science that it could get. Remember what we were doing. We were unlocking docking ports. We were unlocking power generation. We were unlocking more science thingies. I am going to go ahead and really quickly get started right here. And y'all have seen my science ship before. I'm just going to go to the science tab. My root node is going to be the mobile processing lab. She looks like that. I am going to do that. I don't have the nukes yet. Remember, I like running the nukes. So we are going to... If you switch one off, it'll roll way faster. I think both pods should roll in the same direction. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Yeah, that would be an interesting experiment to do. So I've got that. I've got these fuel tanks. I don't even have, like, really big fuel tanks left. Yeah, this is the biggest fuel tank I have. That's pretty sad. I could totally put two of those on there. I've also unlocked these things here. So remember, I put this on my little science ship. I put that. The interesting thing is going to be... What pods do I have? I don't even have any command pods. This is the only... I don't have any command pods. I don't have anything. I just went straight for these things. But the entire point here was how we could make this ship be upgradable. So now that I've got these, I could totally put these docking ports on the top of it. The clampatrons. Yes. I could also put clampatrons on the bottom of it. And watch what I'm going to do here. I am going to put this guy on the tail end of it. I am going to put a clampatron on the tail end of it. And all I'm doing is using docking ports to make my ship upgradable, right? So I will put this thing here, like that, and I'm going to put some not-so-great engines on it, such as these, I guess. That'll do us, right? Also, down here, it'd be really nice to have the bigger solar panels one day, right? So I'm going to get Clampotron Juniors, put them in 2x symmetry, right, like that. I'm just going to leave them there, right? I've also got Clampotrons up here. And what did I do with those before? I took them, rotated them so they were straight, yes. And I put docking ports on the top. These are my little go-home vessels. Right now, my go-home vessel could totally look like this. Oops, I don't even need docking ports, honestly. I could just put that. Then I could put this, like that. I could put my little pod. Remember my little ET science home vessels. I am just putting that, then I will put a parachute. Where's my parachute at? Like that. So I've got an engine. I would put power generation on it. Two of these. Also on the other one. Oh wow, that's not what I wanted to do at all, but I can totally get rid of that like that and then put it back with 2x symmetry. That'll fix it. Now I've got little science return vessels. All of this looks familiar if you've seen me before. Do I have any struts or anything to like push me off the surface? I don't really. I want something like that, so I could use these instead. Just mounting them like that. That looks cool. I'll slap these guys on there. This is going to give me my little, sort of engine nacelle sort of deal, right? Strut it on up. Like that, and like this. Same sort of deal. Up to the middle. So we're missing lots of science experiments, right? We don't have all the science experiments. Look, I basically only have a thermometer. So what could I do? I am going to put a little docking port over here. Like, where are you at, docking port? The Clampatron Jr. Just in 1x symmetry. I'm going to put it right here to make sure that it doesn't miss. And check this out. I'm going to toss a little bit of a science package on here, right? I'm going to take another docking port and put it... not like that, but like... That's odd. Like that. Give me a probe core. Ooh, all I have is that. Actually, let's use this. It's got more surface area. Like that. And I could put some science experiments on here, right? Two thermometers, basically. So there's one. I think 2x symmetry will do it, right? Yeah, two thermometers. So what did I just do? Whenever I say I launch this ship, right, and I get it out to minimus, which we're gonna do in the next episode, I'll get this ship out to minimus. But all it has is a thermometer here. In the future, I could launch a retrofit vessel up to minimus, which we'll do in the next episode. And instead of just this on here, we could use a different probe core. We could have more science experiments on there, and we would redock it. We would undock this guy and toss him. We would redock the new module, and we could add new experiments to our ship. I could do the exact same thing with the communicatrons. So everybody knows how I like to do my little communicatrons, right? I come over here, I put something, kind of out the side, like, How can I do this so that it looks good? That's too big. I don't have the smaller parts yet. What can I do? I want to get a... one of my dudes on there. I always could... I guess I could always put two of these things down. That would not be particularly pretty. Let's see how it looks. Drained of fuel. Drained of fuel. These will get drained of fuel? That is a good point. If you don't disable the crossfeed there, they'll get drained of fuel, Davey says. So I would need to go through there. I can't do it here. I'd have to do it on the pad. Or I could use another thing that would... Yes. Switch auto flow off. You got it. I need to put... I've got that guy on there. It's really ugly right now, but this is as we started. I wanted some way, and I don't really think I have a good way to do it. I need something that would give me more of a standoff, I think. I bet you something like this would work if I put one of these right here. Like that, basically. Yes, and then something like this. Again, I'm just making do because I don't have the parts I want yet. I guess I'm gonna have to do it this way. Will that work? Let's see if that works. Like that. Is that gonna give my probe core enough standoff? We will find out. Not really. I really like how that looks. Alright, Cray77, man, take it easy. Thanks for hanging out for Kerbal Space Academy, which ran long this evening, which I'm perfectly fine with. We've actually gone for 2.5 hours. But I could do the same thing here, right? I don't think I'm gonna do it. I could do the exact same thing here where I could... it's just too ugly. I don't really like how it looks. Oh, why don't I just do it this way? Duh. Do I have a structural component? Yes, I do. Yes, that looks much better. Again, I'm doing the same thing. I'm just putting a little docking port here. Nope, that was incorrect. Am I ever going to be able to grab that docking port again? Probably not. Clip inside of it. Ah, yeah, yeah. Those little docking ports, the nodes are so close together on the little docking ports. It's totally annoying. We can always just toss that part and get another one. That there while I'm there. Put this guy here just to keep it close in. Excellent. Little docking port. Let's look at it this way. There we go. You got to get the daylight behind it, right? Like that. So I could totally do that, and I could totally put another little docking port there. Clampatron Jr. once again in the same sort of direction. Come on, don't do that to me. Don't do me that way. Nope, I guessed wrong. Alright, caught it that time. And I could put the docking port on the bottom of the probe core like that. That looks hideous, honestly. That looks terrible. I'm not even sure I would want to do that, but geez. Say all I had was like a little normal antenna right now. Just playing around here. That's all we had. And then in the future, we could come up with a better design and we could use it instead. That looks freaking terrible. It looks like a tumor on the top of my science ship. One thing that I am kind of missing here. Let's see here. I always put my big... this thing. Do I even have it? I don't even have it yet. No, I do. There it is. Did the same sort of nonsense. Come on. Oh my gosh, it's like every part I pick clips inside of the other parts. There we go. Very carefully now. Like that. Again, using the docking ports again. The long and short of what I'm doing is using the docking ports to create things that I could retrofit these engines. I could put nukes on here if I wanted to. I could retrofit this and put more science experiments on it. I could retrofit this. I could take this off and add another thing. I could make a little, if you've seen my construction rover, I could make a little construction rover looking thing, and I could take this probe core off and put another probe core on that has the better antenna on it, the little dish antenna thing. The same thing with my lander. I could toss together a lander on top of this. And I could say, there's that. You've all seen my minimus lander. I'm going to toss it together very, very quickly. There's that. Here are my two science juniors. Like this. That. I put my little engines on there, which I got already, like that. I put my goo containers on, and I use those as my landing gear, like that. almost, not quite enough. Let's put it on the very bottom. Is that good? Yes, I do need to bring these science juniors down a little bit though to protect that docking port in the middle. There we go. I don't even have the right pod. Jeez, so this is actually pretty rough. I usually use that other pod for it. Would it be a little overkill if I use the docking port? Yeah, it would probably be a little overkill if I did this sort of thing. You can go overboard with this module. I could totally do that. I could put these little things on there. 2x symmetry, that's fine. RCS, don't I have some RCS somewhere? What do I have for RCS? Excellent. I could put these guys on here like this. I mean, I don't even have that yet. But what I could do was with this docking port, I could leave all of this stuff around Minmus, right? And it could be stationed up there with the science ship. And when I research the other pod, the little lander pod instead of the command pod, I could poop, toss this guy and actually replace it with the other pod. I could do the same thing with the science. The new pod could have the new science experiments on it. Or I could do like I did down here, and at the very top of the thing, up here, I could slap a Clampatron Jr. like that with our same sort of little science package on it, right? Just grab that. Since I already did this, oops, didn't need to put that piece there. I just need to put this piece there. And this could be my lander. And as I upgrade the different parts, as I unlock more science parts, I could put them on little nodes and then redock them with the top of the lander. So I don't have to ship a whole new lander out there. I could put a little teeny tiny ship that carries like the new package for it. The new package would just be this, and I could upgrade it. So that is what I'm going to be doing tomorrow. I will save this ship as the Minmus Science Upgrader. And we're going to be taking this ship out to Minmus. We're going to be using that lander right there to get some science. We're going to send the science back in one of these pods, and then we're going to retrofit the ship with new parts. Talking about tumors is exactly what I am going to be doing tomorrow, y'all. So, is that... Nope. It's this one right here, I think. Yes, that is opposite right there. So, again, that was a little bit of a... wackiness. Again, we spent a lot of time farming science. We didn't talk a lot about the retrofit. I think when I do this, I may rename this episode to Farming Quick Science and Starting a New Career Science Mode. But we will get this thing out to Minmus. I will do it probably tomorrow. Either I'm going to skip a day or I'll do it tomorrow. If you follow me on Twitter, I'll tweet the next time I'm going to do it. If you follow me here, it'll show you when I'm going live. But that was Kerbal Space Academy for this evening. It kind of petered out there, right? Because it's like a two-part episode. But again, I hadn't done this one before, and I just wanted to illustrate the possibilities with farming that science quickly, and then how to build a craft, what to research, and how to build a craft we'll be able to upgrade. So I'm going to get this thing upgraded tomorrow. Let's say I'm going to get this thing upgraded tomorrow. We will continue on with this, both to put it in a Minmus orbit, and begin using it to research some more science. If you're interested on how to get more science, we got a couple things from Minmus. We went out into solar orbit. That was really worth a lot. We rolling pinned around the KSE. That was worth some to get us started. Those were some quick ways to do science. We also flew over Kerbin, and as we went over each biome in orbit, we did an EVA report from the Kerbal, and that got us like 8 times 6 different biomes, so 45 or something like that. I am not done, Kid Gamer Nerd. Gamer Nerd. I am just finishing up the Kerbal Space Academy session here, and we will be doing it free play style next. I have a couple things to do free play style involving space planes. So, again, thanks everybody for hanging out. That one, since I'd never done that one before, and it's a little bit of a weird concept, I appreciate everybody having patience with me as I worked out that first time Kerbal Namergird. Namergird. I appreciate everybody being patient while we worked out that kind of test of this. We'll be putting this thing around Minmus tomorrow. I am actually going to be right back. Here's what's going to happen if you're new. I am going to hiccup up the channel. That allows me to cut the Kerbal Space Program, or the Kerbal Space Academy session off, and then start up the new one. It's also going to retweet and stuff like that. But I am going to shut down the stream. It's going to say I went offline for about 30 seconds. It will come right back. I'm not going anywhere. I'm basically just going to hiccup up the stream and cut this session off so that I can upload it to YouTube and stuff separately. We're going to come back and start doing some 8-bit chiptune music. like we do. We'll do free play mode. We'll be working with the space planes there. And otherwise, just basically screwing around. So anyways, everybody, thank you for joining us for Kerbal Space Academy this evening. I will be right back. We will be doing some things. That is Kerbal Space Academy session. Don't go anywhere, because we're going to be crashing some things pretty soon, I think. Oh, geez, Danish, we'll definitely be doing that tomorrow. So, come on back tomorrow, and we will be taking this ship to Minimus and using a little construction rover of some sort, I don't even know, to get this stuff done. So for now, I will be right back. Stream's going to hiccup. I am not going anywhere, but I'm gone.